We had a concert last night in Ashford, Connecticut. This is the second concert we always have at Pomfret School. We are so grateful to be here and performing in this space. Thank you again for coming. My name is Dylan Lomangino. I am the conductor, was the assistant conductor for the past 2 years, while Yaroslav Taroshenko was the principal conductor, who he is now in Nebraska, working at the Omaha Conservatory. So I've taken over big shoes to fill, but we've come a long way. We've had a lot of great music for you today. So thank you. We're gonna start today with Blue Moon, starting our musical journey across the world in Hollywood, California. Thank you. Started in Hollywood, California, with that popular hit. I'm sure all of you recognize at some at some point here. We're starting in Hollywood and going due west across the Pacific Ocean, right to Japan. We're starting with the Japanese lullaby which is based on the Japanese folk song Mori no Fukuro, which means the forest owl. You will hear the melody from this song pass throughout the orchestra, starting with the violas at the beginning. The poem directly translates to, "The forest owl said, I am the guardian of the forest. Fearsome wolves and kitsune and the like won't be allowed to come near. So sleep, sleep, Gorosuke. Who, who?" This is Japanese lullaby. From Japan, we take another long flight over to East Africa. This piece, African Blessing, comes to us from a folk hymn from East Africa where the Swahili language is spoken. The lyrics of the piece convey a message of peace and good luck. Now the actual lyric is one phrase repeated throughout. If this was a choral piece, it would be this same phrase, but since there are no singers here, not saying that any of you aren't singers, but we are string players here, you'll hear the rhythmic melody passed around the orchestra. The actual words are Bwana Awabariki, which means literally, may God grant you a blessing. And you'll hear it start off with the bass, move to the cello and all around, you'll hear it over and over. It's this repeated phrase, bum, 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 bum. And it actually lines up with the words, wa, na, awa, bariki. So, if you want, feel free to sing along if you'd like to, you know. So you'll, the second, the other aspect of this East African music, and all, mostly all African music, is that it's a sense of community with this music, and if you feel so inclined to, you know, stomp or clap or snap along with us, Joan in the back, she'll be playing our djembe. We have a couple of other percussion instruments throughout the ensemble hidden in here. And if you feel free to, you know, stomp, clap, snap along with her if you'd like. This is African Blessing. God grant you a blessing. Yes. Good. So, from Africa, we're taking another flight to Romania. This composer, Bela Bartok, is actually a Hungarian composer who would spend a lot of time along the countryside of Hungary and Romania with an Edison Siller recorder. Anybody still have one of those?
Yeah.
Really? Thank you. So how big is that though? Yeah, so he brought this along with him through the countryside of Romania and Hungary, going to villages, saying, asking villagers to sing their folk songs into this recording machine so that he could bring them back, listen to them. And he was listening for specific things, the roots of the rhythms that they were sang in, the meters, and the use of melodic and harmonic foundations in the songs and dances of those people. And what he did, he would write pieces like this. He wrote this Romanian folk dance. It's actually for piano and was transcribed for orchestra, and for here you'll today for a string orchestra. it has sort of a gypsy violin feel to it. You'll hear a lot of accented heavy notes and some maybe awkward meters, meaning we might switch from 3-4 to 2-4, meaning 3 beats per measure or to 2 beats per measure, and it's jumping around all over the place. So hang on tight. This is Romanian folk dances in 4 movements. Thank you.
Thank you.
That was the end. I should have mentioned that the third and the fourth movement just run right into each other. Sorry. Where are we now? We are heading over to Italy. The great Italian opera composer Gioacchino Rossini premiered this next piece in 1816 in Rome. And you will undoubtedly recognize this piece. It's his most famous overture to the opera Barber of Seville. You may have heard this in Looney Tunes, all sorts of movies. It's all over the place. You're gonna we're gonna start playing it, and you're gonna be like, yeah, I know that one. From somewhere, somehow, it has crossed my path at some time. So this is Gioacchino Rossini's The Barber of Seville Overture. Thank you. Where are we? Oh, Italy. Right on to France. Now this next piece, titled Pieces and Concert, comes from a... Give me a second here. That was fast. We went pretty fast on that last piece there. So we had this composer here, Francois Couperin, who was composing in the late 17th and early 18th century. He published this piece as a larger collection of suites in 1724 entitled Les Goûts Réunis, or The Styles Reunited. The title refers to the reunification of the French and Italian musical styles of the time. So what was happening in Paris at the time, that there was all these composers from Italy and France, and they're competing against each other, trying to be the top composer in Paris, and which style was better, and you know, which one was more musical, which one was more enjoyable to listen to. All these sort of little things that, you know, you might not really could hear now, but back then it was like, you know, the difference between, you know, your top 40 artists right now, and trying to get to the top, basically. So we have the Italian style and the French style. But this composer, Francois Couperin, said, why are we competing? Let's bring them together. So he composed this suite here for in order to bridge the two styles. You'll hear in the first and fourth movement are based in the French style, while the second, third, and fifth movement are based in the Italian style. Try to listen for any distinctions you may hear in those between those movements there. Now the other interesting part about this, this is a solo piece which will feature our principal cellist, Kurt Kaufman, accompanied by the orchestra here. And what's interesting and almost actually pretty humorous is that when Couperin wrote this piece, he didn't specify it for any particular set of instruments. He said, you know, harpsichord could play this, or some bassoons, viola da gamba, just anything except cello. As you see the problem here. Let me read this quote. The cello was considered the lumpen poor relative of the viola da gamba. Not a very nice thing to say about the cello. But look how far we've come. And it just at the time, it just wasn't a solo instrument. But in, I think, about 1920, someone arranged this piece for cello, and it worked out really well. So you're in for a treat today. This is a five-movement piece, a little long, but stick around. We'll take a little break after this and enjoy Francois Couperin's Pieces and Concert. Thank you.
Thank you. fiery ice.
Counted off in German. And last night, my German's not so, or just, I knew the one, two, one, that's what I said to count it, 1, 2, 1. And last night, I made the mistake of saying one pig, one. I said, ein Schwein, Schwein. Yeah, one pig, one. That's just, forget it. So, I asked around the orchestra during this intermission, got like 4 different opinions on how to say two. And I picked one, and I think it worked, right? Did I say pick this time?
Sounded good.
All right, thank you, guys. Musi Den was the name of that song, and it is a traditional German song that dates back to 1827, and it's about a soldier having to leave the woman he loves, vowing to remain faithful until he is back home to marry her. And if you're an Elvis Presley fan, you may have recognized that he used the melody from that song in his song, Wooden Heart. Next, we are going over to Sweden. Now this piece that we're about to play, the Swedish Waltz, comes directly to us from Sweden. A friend of the orchestra, a friend of Jane Vercelli's in Sweden, Patrick Dahlboom, sent us this piece. He is the conductor of the Kristianstad Symphony Orchestra in Kristianstad, Sweden. So this one is right off the presses from Sweden, and we hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you.
From Sweden, we move right on to Norway. This piece is called the Holberg Suite. It's a suite of five movements based on 18th century dance forms, such as a gavotte, a jig, and musette. This is written by Edvard Grieg in 1884 to celebrate the 200th anniversary of the birth of Danish and Norwegian humanist playwright Ludvig Holberg. We will be playing just one of the dance movements, the gavotte and musette. Thank you. Still with us. Haven't lost anybody on any terminals, no baggage loss, no one's stuck in the claims, right? Okay. Let's see, where are we at? So we are at Norway. one last long flight over to Brazil now. This is the Chorus number 1, written by the Brazilian composer Hector Villa-Lobos. This was originally written for guitar and arranged now for a string orchestra. The title, Chorus, is taken from an improvisational genre of Brazilian instrumental music that originated in Rio de Janeiro in the 19th century. This style draws on traditional elements of the Brazilian choro. You'll hear at the beginning a three-note opening phrase, each marked with a fermata being just a held note. And you'll hear that three times throughout this piece. The form of this piece goes as follows: an A section, B section, back to an A section, a new C section, and then, not that kind of C section, and then an A section at the end. Sorry. So you'll hear the main theme three times throughout.
What?
They act like they're surprised that I said that. So you'll listen for the three note opening gesture, and the word coro in Portuguese actually means to cry or lament, though this music and this piece particularly is not exactly sorrowful at all. So this is the Chorus number 1 by Hector Villa-Lobos. Thank you.
Laugh at me. Thank you.
hope you all still have your visas because we are re-entering the United States. Excuse me. This last piece is America the Beautiful, an arrangement for a string orchestra. Thank you all for coming out today. We really do appreciate having an audience to play for, and thank you. And thank you to Pomfret School and Clark Chapel for letting us use this wonderful space. It is such a treat for us to get to play in here and hear how we sound in such an open area. Again, thank you to the town of Ashford for hosting us every Friday night for rehearsals at their town hall. If you yourself or someone you know plays a string instrument and you are looking to get back into playing with a group such as ours, you can find us rehearsing again in the fall in September at Ashford Town Hall, 6:30, Friday nights, every Friday. I believe on your program there's contact information if you find yourself interested or know somebody who may be interested. We're always looking for more people to join our group. We are clearly a friendly group. Right, we love what we do, and we come out every week to do it, and we love being able to perform for you guys as well. So, thank you for your support, and enjoy. This is America the Beautiful, and we'll see you again in winter, right, for our December concert. Okay, so look for us then. Thank you. Thank you.